The end were amazing, and we had people ask us, are they computer simulated? But they're not simulated, they're enhanced, aren't they? So in a similar way to how you might enhance your own photos, but they're real images of what's really happening on Jupiter. Is that right?
I'd say they are neither completely real nor computer generated, completely computer generated, but you use the texture of real images, of real photographs, and process them and reproject them to the perspective you need. So it's a mix of real image, but distorted in a way and enhanced in a way such that you don't see the original image, but the reconstruction of reality enhanced. Yeah, so it's not a true or false, but you try to squeeze out the reality or an enhanced reality out of the more or less ugly raw data.
So Sean, what has been your role in this? You're doing the same data image processing?
Well, to all intents and purposes, what Gerald has done is it's not a snapshot you would take on your phone, because all the color information is encoded then and there, because Juno is spinning and it's flying past Jupiter at a great rate of knots. This is where the reprojection comes in. So Gerald is reprojecting RGB information to come up with the final color image. So like he said before, it can be slightly flat. It can be, when I saw his work, I saw an opportunity to, a creative opportunity to possibly explore improving the kind of aesthetic of the image, rather than, you know, Gerald's goal is to extract as much information from what has been photographed as possible for scientific purpose. I saw an opportunity for an artistic kind of creative expression. Plus, the images themselves are amazing.
Absolutely.
So I was really taken aback, and I had a visceral response to.
I think we all did.
I still do. So every 6 weeks, there's a new batch of images, and Gerald works his magic, and I get an opportunity to come in and try and interpret those in a slightly more aesthetically pleasing way. So I would consider the work that I do is about 5%, and it sits on top of the 95% that Gerald has done, and obviously the rest of the Juno team.
It's incredibly important, and as Scott Bolton said, it, never in his wildest dreams would he imagine Jupiter would be so beautiful, and I think we've all felt that. And in the lecture yesterday, when those images were showed, everybody reacted, everybody gasped. They were beautiful, and yeah, it's been a real pleasure talking to both of you. Thank you very much. So I'm Helen, and we'll see you in the next video.